We're here at Letchworth State Park, one of the most beautiful parks in the world, and we're here like other people come to Letchworth because we want to experience nature. Well, what's more natural than a muon? Now, you might know that electrons and protons and neutrons are subatomic particles that make up ordinary matter. Well, a muon is a subatomic particle that isn't part of ordinary matter. It's about 207 times more massive than an electron, but it has the same charge as an electron. And physicists classify muons in the same family of particles as electrons.
So muons are generated from space. They're generated both from our sun and by things outside of our solar system. And at first, they start off as another particle, a cosmic ray proton. They're very excited, and they travel very quickly towards the Earth. Once they hit the Earth, they'll hit the upper atmosphere. And once they collide with atoms there, they will generate another particle called a pion, which then decays into a muon. Then that muon will travel down to Earth, and it can actually penetrate through several layers, several meters of soil before they eventually decay.
We have put together a project that we're calling Muons Over Letchworth. And the idea here is we want some outreach to the greater community. People come to the park to appreciate nature. It's easy to appreciate the nature that we see in front of us, but there's a lot of nature out there that we are not seeing. We wanted to introduce the idea of these particles that surround us, that pass through us every second, that are fundamental to the universe and that we can only see if we use specialized detectors. The detector system is called the Cosmic Watch Muon Detector. The Cosmic Watch Muon Detectors were designed at MIT, and they made the plans for these detectors open source so that they could be used for citizen science projects anywhere. Now, how do those electronics work? Fundamentally, there is a little piece of plastic inside our enclosure that's called a scintillator. And a scintillator is a material that when a particle strikes it, it takes the energy of that particle and creates a little tiny flash of light, a scintillation. Our electronics can see the light that has been created when the invisible particle passed through. And then displays on the front panel, every time there's a flash, it goes blip with a little LED light, and there's a count that increments every time a new particle comes in. People who come to the park can see on the display flashes of light that represent each arriving muon.
Muons are interesting because we can use them for greater penetration than we could for X-rays. So we can find hidden tombs inside pyramids. We can find magma pools underneath volcanoes. Not only that, but they solidify Einstein's theory of special relativity. The rate at which they decay and the amount of time they have to travel to reach us do not match up. And if it weren't for special relativity, we would detect no muons at the surface of the Earth.
Our primary goal, of course, is for visitors to the park to engage with those detectors, to learn a little bit about the existence of these muons, and maybe inspire a little digging deeper when they get home. Additionally, we're going to deploy a detector briefly underground in the salt mines nearby. And we're going to take a detector up in a hot air balloon. So we're going to have measurements not only from a lot of different places, but importantly, a lot of different altitudes.
Hello, we're here at the American Rock Salt Mine in Geneseo, New York.
And we are approximately 1,200 feet underground.
We had to come 1,200 feet underground to tell you about space.
Yes, because space does affect us even when we are below the Earth. In fact, we are going to be showing you that muons can reach even depths of this surface.
A lot of sensitive experiments have to be set up deep underground to minimize the background effects that cosmic rays have on the material they're attempting to study.
So this Cosmic Watch muon detector has been counting for over 10 minutes here in the mine under 1,200 feet of rock and earth. And so far we've only detected 17 counts. That means the count rate is about 0.025 counts per second, much lower than what we saw at the surface. We're here at the surface of the Earth here in Letchworth State Park, and currently this Cosmic Watch muon detector is reading about 0.51 muons per second.
We're at 5,800 feet currently, and we're reading 0.731 muons per second.
which is quite a bit higher than it was on the ground.
By looking at the count rates in these different locations and different altitudes, we can confirm some of the things that we believe we understand well about muons. For example, muons, which are created in the upper atmosphere, are likelier to be detected if you're in a hot air balloon than if you're a subterranean mine. And so by comparing count rates, we can confirm that the behavior we see matches what we expect.
This project was funded by the American Physical Society and also through an undergraduate research grant through the Geneseo Foundation.
We'd like to thank our friends at the Liberty Balloon Company and our friends at American Rock Salt for helping us with this video.
So I'd really like people, if they're curious and want to learn more about muons, to visit our website, which is www.geneseo.edu/muons, M-U-O-N-S.